On tonight, the search is on for a killer. Three people were shot to death at a West Baltimore row house this morning.
The violence adds to a particularly deadly 2013, which has seen nearly 40% more murders than the same time period last year. Law enforcement leaders addressed the growing violence at City Hall this afternoon. 11 News reporter Kai Reed was there. She joins us live from City Police Headquarters downtown with our big story. Kai.
Well, Rotten Donna Police Commissioner Anthony Batts talked about some overall improvements in the crime rate, but he also talked about that growing cloud over that homicide rate that continues to grow. Nine people have been killed in Baltimore since Sunday.
Two women and a man shot to death in a West Baltimore row house. Homicide numbers 43, 44, and 45 so far this year. The numbers are especially bad in West Baltimore, where the neighborhood patrol chief called the sharp increase in violence there alarming.
It's really taking a pace that we want to get under control. But of course, the angle we're looking at as far as the drugs as well.
Where we are in regards to homicides.
Shifting more resources to the Western District was just one of several initiatives presented by a team of police department leaders called to a legislative oversight hearing Tuesday at City Hall. There have been 14 homicides in West Baltimore this year. Police were called there to the 300 block of Wilson for a shooting Tuesday night.
Our spike is clearly in the Western. We've been aware of that for the last 3 months. Like I said, we've spent a tremendous amount of time. I spent a tremendous amount of time out on streets over there. We will increase the resources and the numbers in that area, and we will increase our activity there.
Commissioner Batts talked about building stronger police relationships with community members that include more than just knocking on doors. He said although more resources might be a short-term solution, stabilizing the Western District, particularly with jobs and employed, educated residents, is also an essential long-term solution. While homicides are up 37%, police say that overall violent crime is down by 6%. Councilman Brandon Scott explained that the committee planned for the meeting with police leaders months ago, but just happened to take place just hours after the triple shooting. He said it's about learning the police plans for improvement and ensuring that they're working.
People are dying in the city, and we want to know that they have a handle on that, but also that they're looking at the big picture and how they can try to work on these issues beforehand, and also to make sure that what they're doing is done in a manner that benefits the citizens.
And there have now been 46 homicides in the city this year. Police say the victim of the shooting earlier tonight in West Baltimore has died. They've also released the names of the victims of the triple shooting earlier this morning. Those victims are Brian Powell, Kishawana Pinder, and Tarika Martin. Reporting live at Baltimore City Police Headquarters, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.